Hello, this is Bill Bullard with RCAF USA, the voice of the independent cattle producer in the United States of America. Well, cattle producers have been conditioned by the beef packing lobby, which includes the nation's big four packers and the National Cattlemen's Beef Association, or NCBA, which is the association that represents the big four beef packers' economic and political interests. And so they've all worked together to convince cattle producers that imports do not compete with U.S. beef production, and instead, they help U.S. cattle producers because imports sell more beef. Now, running parallel to this persistent message from the beef packing lobby, our industry has witnessed numerous closures of beef packing plants. Steve Kay with Cattle Buyers Weekly reports that we've lost 48 beef packing plants just since 1995, which was the year after the North American Free Trade Agreement, or NAFTA, was implemented. And this agreement facilitated an increased volume of beef and cattle imports into the United States. Now, ironically, the beef packing lobby blames RCAF USA for those closures, saying that it was our litigation that kept Canadian border closed to imported live cattle for over 2 years that caused these plants to close. And it was our success in passing country of origin labeling that likewise caused these U.S.-based packing plants to close. It should be noted, however, that producers received the best prices in their history for their cattle at the time that RCAF USA was taking these two important actions. And very recently, the NCBA restated their allegation that it was country of origin labeling that forced the closure of U.S. packing plants, though they failed to mention that the plants were already closing at an alarming rate before COOL was ever implemented. And now there's pretty compelling evidence that it is rising imports and not COOL or other RCAF USA actions that is contributing to the closure of U.S. packing plants. Let's look at that evidence. Cargill, the nation's third largest beef packer, owned the Plainview, Texas beef packing plant, which was one of the major U.S. plants that was recently closed here in the United States. And then let's go back further to 1974 when Congress passed a Trade Act. At that time, that Trade Act provided provisions to give financial assistance for workers who were displaced by rising tides of imports. The assistance is called the Workers' Adjustment Assistance and the Alternative Trade Adjustment Assistance. It's a nice way of saying that your tax dollars are being used to support workers who have been displaced by trade agreements. The requirements for this assistance are, number one, that workers have had to have been let go. Number two, the sales from the firm that let the workers go have decreased absolutely. Number three, that imports of the same product the firm produced have increased. And number four, that those imports have contributed significantly to the decrease in sales and the separation of the workers from the firm. So a petition was filed with the U.S. Department of Labor, and that's the department that administers this assistance. And that petition provided that, number one, the Plainview plant produced box beef. Number two, the plant employed 2,200 workers who were let go. Number three, that imports of beef had increased by over 4,700 metric tons. And importantly, number four, that it was those imports that competed directly against the plant's production and contributed absolutely to the plant's closure. The U.S. Department of Labor found that the petition was accurate and that the workers in Cargill's Plainview, Texas plant were eligible for the trade adjustment assistance they had asked for. Consequently, the U.S. Office of Trade Adjustment granted those workers financial assistance because imports of beef were a principal cause of the plant's closure. So there you have it. The U.S. government has confirmed that your tax dollars are going to support workers whose beef packing plants have closed due to the increase in imports of beef and or cattle. And as an added bonus, your cattle prices are depressed because of these very same imports, and you have no means to compete against them because both Congress and the beef packing lobby has made certain that imported beef and the beef from your cattle is not required to be labeled at retail as to its country of origin labeling. That's significant, and that should cause numerous red flags to be raised. We need to be better informed as an industry if we're going to charge off into the future and provide opportunities for our children and grandchildren. With that, we're out of time. We hope you have a productive week, and goodbye.